Before we move on from the topic of modeling data, I wanted to talk about different options for long-term storage. A general term for this topic is persistence, which refers to persisting data longer than just the runtime of the application. There are many different ways to persist data in this way, and it mostly depends on the scale of the data, how efficient the storage needs to be, and in truth, your skill as a developer. Now, my goal here is just to overview things, as these topics can get very complicated very quickly. Two words you will hear in discussions on persistence are local and remote, or instead of remote, you might hear the word cloud. Local storage simply means that you are storing data for the application on the device which executes the application, the user end device. Both remote and cloud simply mean that the data is stored on some other device. There is no cloud, in case you are wondering. In general, you have two options for storing data locally on a typical operating system. The simplest way is to use the operating system's file input-output streams, which are usually easy to access in Java. In my Sudoku application, I only plan to store data for a single game at a time, so I use this approach. Update game data writes a Sudoku game to local storage, and get game data reads from local storage. If it turns out that a file matching the game data is not found, I throw an exception, which is just a convenient way to know if I need to create a new game entirely. I will discuss exceptions more in part 3. Let's talk about some pros and cons of local file storage. It's usually good for small amounts of storage, often fast and easy to implement and use, and it can be fairly cross-platform compatible. The primary issue with it is that it's not very scalable. Another approach you can use is to create a database. Most databases are written in structured query language, or SQL, or some derivative language of SQL. An easy way to think about these tools visually is that they are basically just spreadsheets. Another common solution is to use an object database, which does not necessarily work like a spreadsheet. There are different ways to implement an object database, so I cannot give you a universal example here. I also cannot recommend one or the other in general. You will have to do your own research on what the current preferred tools are and what makes sense for the operating systems you wish to support. Local databases scale well among small, medium, and large datasets. Often, they are very fast and efficient. They might require the operating system's read and write access, and they can be somewhat complicated to implement and use. Remote storage comes in the same types as the other options we have looked at, but the key difference is that your application will communicate, that is, send, create, read, update, or delete operations to the remote storage system through a network connection or the internet. This comes with some great benefits, but also its own added set of complexity and potential problems. Since you are communicating over the internet, it follows that you will have to use some kind of tool to do that. Some benefits include users being able to share data across multiple devices. It can be made very efficient with a good internet connection. Some potential issues are that, of course, it requires the devices to have network access. Java does have some out-of-the-box tools to set this network communication up, but they can be tricky to use.